Role of toxins in pathogenesis. We will see what are all the different types of toxins which is produced by the plant pathogens and their role and functions in pathogenesis. We will see. So my name is N. H. Shankar Reddy. I am doing a PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So we'll start with the definition. So toxin, any compound which is produced by the microorganism which is toxic to plants is considered as toxin, not only to plants but also for any living systems. Any compound that is produced by microorganisms which is toxic is considered as toxin. So actually usually the toxin is a low molecular weight compound that is produced by the microorganisms like fungi, bacteria and viruses. So this toxin is extremely poisonous at a very low concentration. So even very low concentration, these are very poisonous and extremely toxic. So this toxic, what will do these toxins which injure or which affect the osmotic regulations and which affect the enzymatic reactions or enzymatic functionings which are going in the plant cells, it destructs all these functionings. The enzymatic reactions can be destroyed or the osmotic regulation mechanism can be destroyed due to toxins. So this toxins affect as a maybe a direct action or indirect action, different types of actions of mode of actions will be there of on toxins. We'll see on later slides. So this toxins directly act on a living protoplasm and kill the cells of the plants. So this it acts as a directly on living protoplasm. Due to this, what will happen? The entire plant physiological system can be collapsed. We will see one by one what are all the different types of toxins and their functions and their role. What are all the different types of host specific and non-host specific toxins? Though here Wheeler and Luke in the year of 1963. Classified toxins into three categories, that is phytotoxins, vivotoxins and pathotoxins. These are all the three types of toxins where Wheeler and Luke classified. We will see one by one what is phytotoxin, what is vivotoxin, what is pathotoxin. So the first one is phytotoxin. Here, these are all the compounds produced by the microorganisms which is toxic to plants. So, phytotoxins are the compounds which is produced by the microorganism that is toxic to plants is called phytotoxins. Phyto means plant, toxin to toxin. So, these toxins are toxic to plants that is produced by the microorganism. So, where these phytotoxins will produce few or almost no symptoms. Here the phytotoxin has no role in pathogenicity. So these phytotoxins won't play a major or big role in pathogenicity. So examples are alternaric acid or cochleobolin. These two are comes under phytotoxins. So the second one is vivotoxin. So the term vivotoxin was coined by Diamond and Wagner in the year of 1953. So the term concept, the term was given by Diamond and Wagner. So if we define vivotoxin, these are all the substances produced in the infected plants by the pathogen. So here, due to the pathogen infection, the plants produce a toxin called vivotoxin due to the pathogen infection. So these are vivotoxins are the toxins that are produced by the plants due to the infection of a pathogen. And these are it acts so here vivotoxins which play a few of the functional roles are the due to this toxin few of the functional roles like production of diseases. It produces disease symptoms but not itself act as the initial agent of the disease. It produces few of the symptoms but it is not the initial agent that can initiate the disease. So it produces symptoms that determine the virulence. Here the vivotoxin is usually non-specific toxin. We'll see what are all the what is the difference between a specific toxin and non-specific toxin in later slides. So here the fusaric acid is the example of vivotoxin. So the third one is pathotoxin. So pathotoxin, the name itself indicates this is a toxin which is produced by the plant pathogens. So the toxin produced by the plant pathogens which play a major role in disease production and development. It is a very important toxin which produce the major disease symptoms, and play a major role in disease production and development. Here This pathotoxin mainly determines the pathogenicity and the production of a characteristic symptoms of the disease. So it plays a major role of the disease, and also characteristic symptoms also to be the responsible for the production of pathotoxins. So example, pyriclarin, tentoxin, tabtoxin and victorin, these are all the host specific toxins that is produced by the plant pathogens that comes under the group of pathotoxins. We have seen all what are all the three types of toxins, that is phytotoxins, vivotoxins and pathotoxins with example. We'll see the difference between what is a host specific toxin and a host non specific or non host specific toxins. We'll see here host specific toxins, there's a metabolites which is produced by the plant pathogens. Here what we have to understand is selectively toxic to the susceptible host, that's why it's called host specific. It is only specific to the specific host, that is selectively toxic to the host plants only. If we inject it into the non-host plant, it has no action because it is a host specific toxin which only kills or starts pathogenesis on selective host only. It is a little or non-toxic to non-susceptible host. It is not much considerable. So host specific toxin as a selective toxin that is only applicable for the selective host only, whereas a non-host specific toxin, it affects selective host and non-selective host. There is no selectivity, that is called a non-specific host. It affects or targets the non-host plants and also the other species of plants. Non-host plants and other species of plants also can be affected by the host non-specific toxin. We will see few examples comes under that is a host specific and non-host specific, so that it will be very easy to understand. So these are all the host specific and the host non-specific toxins produced by the plant pathogen. This is a host specific toxin. These are all, we'll see, these are all the host specific toxins. We'll see HV toxin or victorin. This is produced by Helminthosporium victoriae. HSC toxin, HS toxin, HMT toxin, ACL toxin, AL toxin. So these are all the different types of host specific toxins produced by the plant pathogens. And on the right side, corresponding side, plant pathogens that is produced by the host toxins has also been given. So these are all the host non-specific toxins. These are all the host non-specific toxins produced by the plant pathogen. That is alternaric acid, fusaric acid, oxalic acid, syringomycin, or tase toxin, fasciolytoxin, tab toxin, tent toxin. These are all the different types of host non-specific toxin produced by the plant pathogens. Here, these toxins will play a major role in pathogenesis, whereas the enzymes plays a major role in entering into the plant system or getting the energy materials or the nutrients from the plant system. Whereas these toxins plays a major role, which is very poisonous and toxic to the plant system, that alter the physiological functions or the expression of disease symptoms or the disease spread or further entire pathogenesis can be carried out due to the production of toxins.